Welcome to this presentation of STM32 MP1 Wiki. STM32 MP1 is a microprocessor, dual Cortex A7 with a Cortex M4. STM32 MP1 is using Linux operating system on A7 and can run at 800 MHz. Cortex M4 is a coprocessor with real-time capability and runs at 208 MHz. We remind here the software release flow. The product has usually two major releases per year. Major releases follow kernel LTS releases. We currently support two kernel LTS releases in the same time, and we support each during 2 years. Some minor releases are regularly provided under GitHub. Wiki.st.com is our user guide for STM32 MPU products. You will find there many useful information on the products, such as how to get started with STM32 MP1, how to develop on top of STM32 MP1 device. You can also find some information related to software license. On the last tab, a link is dedicated to previous STM32 MP1 releases. How to find information in the STM32 MPU wiki. With the search, you can find articles by keywords. With the top tabulation, you can browse proposed links. In development zone, you can navigate with a menu tree on the left. In the legal notice tab, you will find many information on licensing. Please take care on it. On the Wiki Archive tab, you will find information on previous releases. There is one wiki version archived for each open ST Linux release. A dedicated area allows to get started with the product. Follow the proposed links and start step by step using the product. Unpack the board, flash an image on the board, execute basic commands on the board, use the demo launcher, create a simple application on Linux side from developer package, use MCAT firmware with STM32 kubeIDE and STM32 kubeMP1 package. Let's go now to the development zone. The STM32 MPU wiki is a set of articles, several hundreds of articles. They help getting started with practical information, articles on the hardware, on the software components. The wiki also provides many information on how to develop with a product and some useful how-to and trainings. The prerequisites for PC installation are provided to develop on STM32 MP1. The different software packages are presented: starter package, developer package, distribution package, STM32 kubeMP1 firmware package, forum 4 firmware. The article "Which package should you need?" explains the package contents and their usage. The ecosystem release note is the main release note. It describes many main features and highlights of the release, and it is a pointer on the different other release notes. Embedded software, OpenST Linux on i7 side, STM32 kubeMP1 on M4 side, and also on tool release notes, STM32 kubeprogrammer, STM32 kubeMX, STM32 kubeIDE, signing tools, keygen tool. The ecosystem release notes describes for each component the main restriction. It also provides information on minor releases under GitHub. The resources are listed for useful reference documentation on the product: application notes, datasheet, errata sheet, reference manual, schematics and user manual for the boards, user manuals for the tools. You can follow also the links to get started with the software and the hardware. The hardware blocks are presented with peripheral overview. You can click on any peripheral and then you can follow the links to the peripheral description, how to configure device 3 for this peripheral. The software architecture is presented, platform boot is presented with ROM code, TFA, and uBoot for the boot chain. Security is presented with TFA, Opti. Platform configuration with device 3 is available for each peripheral. Linux kernel components are presented. You can also have Linux framework overviews. You can access to the board descriptions, DK2 discovery board, EV1 evaluation board. Some articles explain how to use and build different packages and their different components. The tools to develop are presented: STM32 Cube Programmer, STM32 Cube MX, STM32 Cube IDE. The Yocto system build is presented with Open Embedded and BitBake tool. Tracing and debug tools are presented. For tracing tools, most useful are DMessage and ftrace. For monitoring tools, NetData is very useful for performances. For debugging tools, GDB articles are very useful. Article Linux tracing, monitoring and debugging is very useful. You can click on each component and have dedicated overview how to use the framework and some tracing and debugging information. Here is an example of a wiki page for ADC Linux component from IO Linux framework. It shows device 3 configuration for this component. Some how-to section is available: how to customize the software, how to build the software, how to run use cases, with some command lines to execute for running use cases, for instance with GStreamer. How to debug and trace information, how to use dynamic debug for each framework. Finally, the wiki gives access to some training material. Some of our training resources can be found on ST Community with forum and knowledge articles. STM32 MP1 MOOC workshop also provides some useful presentation and hands-on to use the product. We wish you a good time browsing with our STM32 MP1 wiki.